Thank you so much for taking the time to hear the powerful word of truth from Prophet Bishop H. Walker. By way of special announcements, join Prophet Walker at True Life Pentecost Church every second Sunday of each month in Atlanta, Georgia at 957 Metropolitan Parkway at 4:30 p.m. Also join in with True Life every fourth Sunday of each month in Charlotte, North Carolina at 300 North Tryon Street, located at the Public Library of Charlotte. For further details, go to www.truelightpentecost.org and click on announcements for any current events. Thank you so much for supporting Prophet Walker and the True Light Ministry. Be encouraged and be blessed.
You are now viewing Prophet H. Walker and True Light Pentecost Church. Those that are viewing and seeking after righteousness, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
That ye may walk honestly toward them that are without, that ye may have lack of nothing. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope.
Yes.
For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God raise.
Mission Church.
Preach, Bob.
Two effect, one soul. Amen. See, we are too much looking for a multitude of crowds. But again, it, brothers and sisters, it's not going to happen.
Amen.
Prophecy has been forwarded. I've seen it many, many times. Straight as a gate, narrow the way that leads life, and few there be that can find it. Now, that's the word of God coming from God Himself.
Yes.
So again, we have to understand. Sometimes we get caught up in the imaginations of this world, and we're looking for things other than what God has already exemplified for us to look for.
Amen.
We look for His coming.
Amen.
And we do the work that He has called for us to do until His return. Amen. If it's one, if it's none, if it's five or six, we still do our work. But we are about God's business, and nothing else matters. Again, but God's business,
amen.
The kingdom of God, amen, that's the only thing that counts in this life's journey. So again, we have to always be aware not to let the circumstances of this world affect you in any wise.
Right.
Have your mind made up. And your mind is not predicated on somebody else's mind, whether it's made up or not.
Amen.
Your mind, your desire, your heart's decision, that rests with you. And again, I've set a good example for this church.
Amen.
And I have found through the years, if y'all hear me tonight, if you put God first,
amen,
I don't care what the adversary brings against
you,
God will always bring you through.
Oh,
amen. Now I'm 84 years old, and I tell you, I feel probably better than I felt 20 years ago. Now, you may take me home tomorrow, or next week, or next month, whatever. But I'm saying how I feel today. And when you give me somebody, when you live all you know how for the Lord, this puts you in a position to find favor with Him. Then when trouble comes your way, no matter how it's multiplied, if somebody can hear me,
amen,
God will step in right on time in your life. But you have to understand, you've got to put the kingdom of God first. Now there's no way, and I hope nobody take this wrong, but it's the word of God. You going to make me work on a Sunday and tell me I'm off money. You ain't going to do that to me.
Come on, Father. Amen.
You got to prove to God when you find me two times.
Yes,
how you ain't going to do that. You ain't going to do that to me.
Amen. Right.
Well, I can't take off Monday and come to church on Sunday since I'm an officer in the church.
Amen.
Because they don't want you in the church. Why can't you understand what I'm saying?
Amen.
The enemy is out to close the church of God. That's why God said trees get near the way. Only a few that be is going to find it. You're only going to have a few in the remnant church. But that few has to be dedicated to the proposition that God is. Yes. And never surrender the principles of God. I don't care what it looks like.
Right.
If you don't have not a quarter in your pocket, God will take care of you.
Amen.
I promise you. What's that song they sing? God's on his sparrow.
Oh.
I know he watches you.
Praise
God. And I'm more than a sparrow.
Right.
That me. He didn't die from a sparrow.
Amen.
First Thessalonians.
Brief, Rob.
I think I want chapter. Chapter 4. Jump right into verse 12.
That ye may walk honestly toward them that are without, and that ye may have lack of nothing. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope.
Yes.
For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him.
Yes.
For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep.
Yes.
For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout.
The Lord himself, God himself, shall descend from heaven. Now descend means something that's coming down.
That's right. Amen.
Exit means going up. Descend means come down.
Amen.
So he's in heaven right now.
Amen.
And he's getting ready to come down.
Pretty
quick now. Read.
With the voice of the archangel and with the trump of God and the dead in Christ shall rise first.
Yes.
Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord.
There shall we be with the Lord forever.
Amen.
So again, brothers and sisters, I'm trying to tell you, it's not about this earthly journey. If it's separated from God, it's about this earthly journey with God and doing his will. Doing the bidding of the Lord. Again, this separates you from them that are of the world. You can make all kind of excuses. Well, I've done this and I've done that. And don't make no excuse. Serve God in the fullness of that which you know how. Do all you can for God. And I promise you he will not let you down.
Amen.
Now, I want you to take a look at chapter 5. Pick right up in verse 6.
Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober.
Do what?
Watch and be sober.
You got to keep your mind on God all the time.
Amen.
Amen.
You can't go to sleep. You can't let your guard down.
Amen.
And it's right around the corner. The more church you miss, the weaker your faith and your resolve becomes. And the more church you miss, the more easier and more comfortable you are missing church.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Don't never get that spirit in you.
Oh,
yeah. I'm going to church. Well, if you do, we're going to write your pink slip. But you go ahead and start writing now because I'm not missing no more Sunday service. Watch your shit. In a hospital, it's totally different. In a hospital, they have a procedure where they try to rotate people because people get sick on Sunday, you know. So a hospital is totally different than a plant.
Man.
A plant is run by a few people at the top of a corporation.
Yep.
While you working on Sunday making them money, they're on the golf course worried about their golf score.
All right.
Wow.
I'm telling you what I know.
True.
They don't care nothing about what I got to go to church. They're working people right now 12 hours a day.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
I told some people that I wouldn't work no 12 hours to get no 7 days. But no, I'm not. You ain't gonna do that to me. Why are they doing this? Because American people have been so brainwashed. They're caught up in this atmosphere.
Yeah.
Well, if I don't get there, and you know what the company will say? Oh yeah. Well, if they don't work 12 hours a day, slave labor, we'll send our plane over to China. Well, I tell you what. Take your church, your plant to China, and you go to China right along with it. But leave your money here. I wish I was the president. Anyway, I stopped this bullying. They're doing this because they want to send their friends to Pakistan, to India, working 12 cents an hour. They want to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, they want too much money. Complaining about raising minimum wage to $15 an hour. Well, look, they want $15 an hour. That's too much money. Well, how much you making?
Amen.
Amen.
Them corporate business entities, them people, I'm talking about people, call the corporation office, I'm talking about people.
Amen.
Their wives pay more for their beautician than you make all year.
That's right.
Amen.
If you base it on what them beautician work for them people make.
Yes.
They work for one or two people and make more than you make working 12 hours a day all year long.
Amen.
Don't be no fool. Don't be no slave for nobody. It's come 1960. That's a standard. No, I'm not gonna work on Sunday. Why I'm a minister.
Yeah.
I sing in the choir. I got to testify on Sunday. If I'm just, I want to hear somebody else testify on Sunday. I want to clap my hands and sing my song to Zion. I want to worship my God. And go to scripture and prove it. Paul preached it on the first day of the week and show me where the first day of the week is Sunday.
Right, amen.
If the Sabbath is Saturday, which it is,
right.
Then the first day of the week is Sunday.
Right.
So if you have 7 days in the week.
Amen.
And I can come from Saturday to Sunday.
All right.
Sabbath to one.
Amen.
Or first if you want to apply.
Amen.
But don't, please, don't treat me like I'm some kind of animal. I'm not a green card carrier.
All right.
I'm an American citizen.
Right. Amen.
Sometimes you got to stand up and let go.
Yeah.
They told the apostles, don't preach in that name of Jesus. We'll do something to you. But they kept on preaching in the name of Jesus. And then when they got beat and wanted to kill themselves, a couple of them, Sanhedrin members stood up and said, oh, better not go too far with these, because they might be like they say they are. They
Amen.
Might be of God. You better be careful.
Amen.
And you know what? It shook them up.
Yeah.
Say, well, maybe we won't kill them, but we sure gonna beat them good.
Right.
Ain't no beating gonna stop a child of God.
Amen.
Ain't no firing gonna stop a child of God.
Amen.
Ain't no heart attack gonna stop a child of God. Ain't no tumor gonna stop a child of God. Lucia, in the name of Jesus, I'm going on. I'm pressing toward the heart. Take away everything I got, but you can't take my Jesus. Why? I won't let you.
Amen.
I can't stop you from taking this. I can't stop you from taking. But I ain't gonna let you take my Jesus.
Amen.
You can stop that foolishness right now.
Amen.
I'm telling you something, church. You gotta stand up and be counted. And those of you in my way of YouTube, you cowards, don't watch me.
Amen.
You cowards, don't leave me on me. Be counted. I don't even want you to watch me.
Amen.
Don't take the time to leave me on me because I ain't gonna ask you back.
Amen.
Well, you're doing a good job, Lucia.
Amen.
Good job. And you big in there, coward. Wait till your reckoning day comes.
Amen.
Then call me and it'll be too late.
Lord.
Talk about Charlotte. Amen. We're going to get a church in Charlotte.
Amen.
The grace of Almighty God. Hallelujah. Been on my heart for 3 or 4 years now. Heaven.
Yeah.
And we got to step out on faith.
Amen.
So income tax time, we're going to take that money and walk it right into Charlotte.
Yeah.
And the first business spot we find. Down here.
Yes,
Lord. I'm gonna sign up and preach the gospel.
Amen.
God, you know it.
Yes,
somebody got to know what is in this truth.
Amen.
And God has chosen us.
Yes.
Where am I at, daughter?
1 Thessalonians 5:1. For they that sleep in the night, and they that be drunk and are drunken in the night. But let us who are of the day be sober. Putting on the breastplate of faith.
Now, night and day is the parable that we of the day or of the knowledge of God.
Be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for a helmet, the hope
be sober.
Of salvation.
And that word sober means you got to be, have your mind right. Don't let your mind be drifting off here, drifting all there, and somebody telling you this, and you're confused here. Be sober.
Yeah.
Have your mind steadfast and steady.
Yeah.
And let me say this. I don't care who needs holiness.
Amen.
You stay.
Amen.
You stay.
Amen.
down. Call them, call them to be chosen. They are called the pure chosen.
Amen.
Esther was chosen to go before the king unannounced, facing death. And she, listen, I'm talking about a true story. And I told you that before. Every story in this book is recorded for a reason. Bible said for our admonition. That young girl went before the king unannounced, facing death, because God chose her to represent a light for the Hebrew people that were about to be destroyed. But first of all, God didn't let his people be destroyed.
That's right. Amen.
But he chose one. Why didn't he send an angel with a great big battle axe? No, he chose a human being.
Amen.
He chose a young girl to go before the king and plead the case and the cause of God.
Yeah.
And that daughter praised God when she fasted and prayed. She said, I'm going.
Thank the Lord.
And I'm going to do what my calling be. I'm going to tell the king, you got to turn God's people loose.
Yeah.
You can't kill those people because they're God's people.
Hallelujah.
And look at me, because I'm one of them too. Hang me, I'm hanging me too.
Amen.
I imagine she said, King, what is wrong with you? Are you crazy?
Yeah.
You fool with God's people.
Right.
People, when they fool with God's church, don't you know God ain't going to let them go but so far? Because he got to have a church. Who going to bear witness to this truth if we don't? Ain't nobody else left. Such in that old unity. You don't find nobody left.
No.
Right,
talk about old Jerusalem. It's all confused. They pushed in Christians. There ain't no Christians over in Jerusalem.
Right.
Not now. I bet me on that.
Amen.
Not one church baptized in Jesus' name. Not one church that don't celebrate the healing festival, Christmas and Easter, over there right now.
Amen.
All of them Trinitarians.
Yeah.
Or Catholic.
Yeah.
Or Orthodox.
Yeah.
Name you one Jesus-only church over there.
Amen.
You can't. Church of the Apostles of Jesus only church.
Amen.
Paul said one Lord, that means one God, one faith, one teaching, and one baptism.
Amen.
That's in the name of Jesus, not Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Amen.
We represent that church, and we represent it by a moral standard God has given to the church to separate his church from people in other churches. That's why you wear a veil covered, daughter. And those of you don't wear you know, you don't want to come, you don't want to wear no veil covering. Don't wear.
All right.
And say it for the judgment of God. And let this testimony come to you.
Amen.
When you heard that prophet say you got to wear a veil covering. Yeah, but I didn't know. I didn't believe. Oh, take your part. Right there with the devil's children in the lake of fire. You know, arguing about it. You know, debate about it. You heard the gospel message. And we're not going to back down. We're not going to take down. And cowards don't need to apply to this walk.
Amen.
Amen.
This is for people with steadfastness. This is for people with some backbone. And the Bible says, if you weak, get the weak, say you strong.
Amen.
You can't be anything but what God chose you to be.
Amen.
And that's to bear witness of this great truth.
All right.
He leave, she leave, or whoever leave, stay.
Amen.
And pray. Don't forget to pray.
Amen.
And pray all the time.
Amen.
Meditate on the word of God all the time.
Amen.
Whatever you're going through, pray. And don't let no pity party overtake you.
Amen.
Pray for a minute and you get yourself together.
Amen.
Start saying, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. You get happy.
Amen.
You get happy.
Oh.
Hallelujah. Made a promise.
Yes, Lord.
He wouldn't leave us, but don't you leave him.
Amen.
Now somebody needs to take heed to this.
Yes.
And all of this mess of missing church, and missing church, it ain't nothing but the devil trying to close down the church of God. And that's why they're doing it. And why people can't see that, I don't know. Politicians, please, I wouldn't walk across the street to vote for now one of them.
Amen.
Y'all the same. I'm a conservative. I don't care what y'all.
Amen.
You're a devil.
Amen.
And a coward on top.
Thank
hallelujah.
You.
Making people work 12 hours a day like they slave. They, praise God, they stopped that way back in the 1920s.
Amen.
They stopped that. You used to call it sweatshops.
Yeah.
Make people work from sun up to sundown.
Yeah.
Like mules.
Amen.
Yes.
And don't feed them too much. Just feed them enough to go to work.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody called me and said, "Went to sleep on the job." Man called me and said, "Yeah, you worked me 12 hours a day. Yeah, I got tired of sleep."
Amen.
And I ain't the only one. The foreman said, "Yeah, I know it, but you ain't supposed to sleep on the job. If you work 12 hours a day, you got a family. Well, when am I going to spend time with my children? I got to identify with my children growing up.
Amen.
It's good to have them in a daycare. And you ought to thank God for True Light Christian Life. From this one, every single day of your life. So you can go to work and you know you burn it down. My children know. Like, there ain't no sex maniac watching you.
Oh, amen.
Ain't no pedophile watching you. Oh. Ain't no sissy watching you. Ain't no lesbian watching you. A child of God's watching you with an angel by your side.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
We got to stand up and be counted now.
Mm-hmm.
And let's not let the people trick us into going into no kind of world situation where I'm afraid I'll get fired if I stand up and tell that person I'm not going to work no more on Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Now, I said, except you work in the hospital. That is totally different.
Amen.
You can't compare a corporation, a plant, with no hospital.
Amen. Amen.
A corporation, a plant is not a hospital.
That's right.
Amen. Yeah. Yeah. Nobody gets sick and go to no plant say I'm sick. Well, no, you got to have a rotating system in a hospital because people get sick every single day.
Yeah.
And they ain't got no faith, they're going to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
So they got to be people there. Ain't God merciful?
Amen. Mm-hmm.
So it's totally different. But when you work in a plant and they're going to make you work a double shift, or a shift and a half, and you got to work this Sunday, but you can be off Tuesday or Wednesday.
Mm.
No, I'll take off Tuesday and Wednesday, but I work Tuesday and Wednesday, but I'm not going to work on Sunday.
Amen.
Mm. Are you going to tell us what you do? No, I'm just telling you I'm not going to work on Sunday. Mm. So in case you're running short, maybe you better get somebody for Sunday.
All right. Look.
I'm going to church.
Hallelujah.
I'm going to my church. I'm going to serve my God on Sunday. I'm going to sing my song to the glory of God. I'm going to sing out of no matter. I'm still going to sing to the glory of God. Do that.
Amen.
Praise God. And God won't let you down.
Amen.
Believe me, church. God ain't going to fail you.
Nope.
But don't fail God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And if you think the going is getting too tough, come to this mountain and stretch out for a minute or two. Talk to me. Tell the Lord I got a little weakness somewhere, and then I want you to take it out. He'll take it out.
Amen.
If you let him.
Amen.
But don't praise God. Don't say, "Lord, make me strong." You know you want to be weak all along because the same you want to do when you're weak, and you're complaining on your weakness.
Thank you so much for taking the time to hear the powerful word of truth from Prophet Bishop H. Walker. By way of special announcements, join Prophet Walker at True Life Pentecost Church every second Sunday of each month in Atlanta, Georgia at 957 Metropolitan Parkway at 4:30 p.m. Also join in with True Light every fourth Sunday of each month in Charlotte, North Carolina at 300 North Tryon Street, located at the Public Library of Charlotte. For further details, go to www.truelightpentecost.org and click on announcements for any current events. Thank you so much for supporting Prophet Walker in the True Light Ministry. Be encouraged and be blessed.
Blog Talk Radio.